It's a 366 predator big cat. We're already in the group of the great big cats, the Panthera. So we are in the genus Panthera, where you have Panthera leo, you have Panthera tigris, and you have Panthera pardus. Let's take this example. Okay, Panthera leo is the lion, Panthera tigris is the tiger, of course, and Panthera pardus is the leopard. Of course, you have other cats in there, Panthera onca, which is the jaguar, Panthera oncia, which is the snow leopard. But we'll take the first three to make a simple understanding. The Panthera leo, the lion, Panthera tigris, the tiger, Panthera pardus, the leopard. The column, all of these three are 3, 6, 6. Their predominant level is 6, the capacity is 6, the base level is 3. Now we come into columns. So the column comes in when you have narrowed down to a very small group, let's say the family, yeah, or almost even the genus here, the genus being Panthera. Now you want to differentiate between the strength, between the unusual feature, maybe the style of hunting, any unusual feature or characteristic that differentiates the lion from the tiger from the leopard. Here comes the column. In the column, you are going horizontally across the entire level. And in a way, the column may look a little similar to capacity. But what is different is that the column comes at the very end, when you've understood the capacity, where you've understood the predominant level, where you have an idea of the group you want to prescribe. Now, within the small genus or within the small family, you want to differentiate the available species, or you want to differentiate remedies that come close. That's where the column helps you. For example, in Panthera leo, we've given it column 10, which is like platina of the aurum or the of the periodic table. Whereas in Panthera tigris, we've given it column 11. And with Panthera pardus, we've given it column 8. So once you know you want to prescribe, let's say, a big wild cat to your patient, now you say, is he really like column 8? Now these columns in a way are similar to that of the periodic table, but they have a slight shade of difference. And that has been given to you in the invertebrate chart. Yeah, it's also explained in the quick book, I think, in detail. Yeah, so the columns have been given to you here. Okay. Now, the thing with Panthera pardus is he behaves, the Panthera pardus individual, just like the Panthera pardus or the leopard in nature. They both behave like column 8 individuals. What do I mean? Yes, they want power and they want strength and they are dictatorial and they want what they want and they want to be in control. This is all level 6. But they will really work and push against resistance. They will challenge unnecessarily. They will end up being in situations which are suffocative and challenging just because they want to prove they are smarter. This is a typical quality of column 8, for example. So if you have in the person who is has all the features of 366 and a big cat, but he has this kind of a challenging nature where he unnecessarily gets into confrontations, or he himself proactively likes to be in challenging situations to prove even a stronger person that in fact he is more stronger. This is the pushy, tedious, tenacious quality of column 8, and he may need Panthera pardus. Panthera Leo, on the other hand, has a slightly different way of behavior. We've given it column 10, which means it's like Platina. He doesn't need to prove. He doesn't need to push and challenge the bully like the leopard. He is there, royal, regal, extremely dictatorial, proud, arrogant, loves to throw out orders, delegates things, completely in control of himself, enjoying his aura. This is a Platina-like feature. Column 10, in the center of the entire row, happy, comfortable, and totally confident about his power, and will do anything to maintain it. Now we go to Panthera Tigris. In Panthera Tigris, we have given it column 11, corresponds more to aura. Panthera Tigris, or tiger, is actually the largest wild cat. The lion is not. But the tiger is not as arrogant as the lion. He does not have the show and glamour like the Platina or like the lion. He's a lone cat, hunts for himself. In nature and in as a human, Panthera Tigris individuals are individuals who will work, who can be good leaders, but they don't just delegate, they work. They feel guilty if they have made a wrong decision. They feel responsible for the group. It's not about arrogance and show and glamour like the Panthera Leo. It's about responsibility, being there. They can be tough. They can be very tough independent bosses. But they will be responsible and they will want to do their best, and they will feel guilty if they don't give in their best. So that's the difference between the Panthera Tigris individual and the Panthera Leo, who is much more arrogant, delegating, dictatorial, also a bit lazy. Okay? So what have the columns done? The columns have, in a way, they talk about the capacity within the genus or within the family, which one has what kind of a capacity, not necessarily more or less. It's also about more or less, but it's also about that unusual feature of that capacity, unusual feature of behavioral mechanism of that cat within the group of cats. So the column helps you, again, I'm repeating myself, the column helps you once you are within a narrow group of remedies in the same family. Now when you want to compare the strengths of each of these, the capacities of each of these, and also if there is any specific unusual behavioral mechanism in their survival, all these features together make the column. And this was a perfect example to explain you the three. Panthera pardus, the leopard, is column 8, always challenging the bully. Panthera Leo is column 10, big show and glamour of his position. Column 11, Panthera Tigris, more a responsible person wanting to hold his position and keeping everyone together or doing his job well.